Sheryl Crow has been an international sensation with her fusion with rock and country blending together. We have ha actually reviewed a couple of artists who fused two different genres so far this week, that we have Beyoncé with country and R&B, The Corrs with Celtic and pop rock, and now we're having another one called Sheryl Crow, who has been fusing alternative rock to country. And she has been
put on a poncho, played for mosquitoes, and drank till I was thirsty again.
Artist. And with all the albums she has actually released for this year called Evolution. And today, as a true icon to every woman out there for making music and making great music too. And today, I'm saying this again, I do apologize. We are redoing an album review of Sheryl Crow's Evolution. Hello guys, today we are doing an art album review, not an artist review, but an album review of one of my absolute favorite singers of all time. Like, The Corrs are one of my absolutely favorite bands of all time. I'm really glad I really did a album review of them. And now we're doing on Sheryl Crow herself and her new, brand new album that she's done called Evolution. I think that's how to spell it. Evolution, Evolution. And I have to say, I listened to it on the radio. I think it was on Jeremy Vine one point when he did it on Album of the Week. And when I first heard about it, I got to review this woman. Because this album, I always love Sheryl Crow. I love The First Cut Is the Deepest. I loved Tuesday Night Music Night, I think that's what it's called, the album, her first album. 31 years old that album is. I can't believe it. It was released in, she's a big well-known singer in the 90s. She's real big everywhere. And well, a no-brainer, I've got to do an album review of this woman. So, like I do in any video, I mean, absolutely no disrespect for anybody I talk about in this video. This is all based on my opinion and public use information that I gathered from the internet and combined into one video. And every time we fact check our resources and give out opinions, no damage will take place on the artist and the artist. And just to give you guys a bit of a reminder that this is someone else's music that I am critiquing on. So let's all keep the comment section down, peace and love and everything nice. I know I'm sound like Mary Poppins, but we'll have always have to keep things nicer down on YouTube and making sure our opinions are always intact. Well, being said, let's get in today's video, which is an album review of Sheryl Crow's Evolution. Now, I have to tell you that this album delivered a very clear original music that Sheryl Crow has done over the years, which is country and alternative music that she has done. And I really do like it. I really don't like it if she does change her music around to make it more, you know, young people and everything else. I'm like, a lot of young people will love Sheryl Crow no matter what, because I think there's a lot of people out there who really likes older music, and I love it. I absolutely love old music. I really love it. It's so original and it's so incredible. And a lot of new artists have been using that so often, like Dua Lipa, like combining 80s music into her music and her songs and everything. She's done that plenty of times, and I love that of her. And I always love Dua Lipa. I know her new album's coming out soon. I think it's coming out this week. There will be an album review of that one, so be prepared on that one. But no, nothing's changed. Nothing's change within her music, which is good, and I really do like that. I personally enjoyed Do It Again, which is her new album. Even she swore in it. I think she said the F word quite a numerous times. And it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. If artists I grew up and liking when I was in secondary school or primary school as well, because I listened to Sheryl Crow when all in my life, it doesn't matter. Really, really does not matter. Everyone swear. I swear all the time. I'm a big potty mouth with swearing. So it does not matter. It really does not matter. And I think, like, yeah, I think you only heard her saying it twice, all right, in the chorus, and then she stopped. Then she stopped, and I really loved that song as well. It's very country vibe, and when I first listened to that track, I just finished listening to The Corrs, and that album just brings me back to The Corrs, and I just love it so, so much. I like it. Oh, I just love that style. I've just personally enjoyed it. I love Love Life, and because it's another favourite of mine on the album, like Do It Again, and I really enjoy Love Life as well, because it gives out real positive vibes into the album. It's like with Sheryl Crow, this is what her music was like for years, giving out positive vibes and give that nice, lovely, warm feeling, like, all I wanna do is have some fun. You will like that rendition when that I made. But I really do love the album itself. I really enjoyed the style that it always brought out in, her original style, that girl on the guitar and everything else. It's just such a good song. Is a really great song. I really do like All I Want to Do, and all the other ones she's done. I like If This Makes You Happy. I love that song. I might try and do you know, an anniversary of one of Sheryl Crow's albums. I know she did her 30th anniversary of Tuesday Night Music Night. I might try and do that. Let me know down in the comments below if you want me to do that review. But honestly, the lyric writing is just absolutely fabulous. I always love Sheryl Crow as a fan. I love her music. I love her style and her attitude into songwriting. It really, really gives that good key. You can't change and don't walk away. The best ballads that she wrote. That those songs have so much meaning. Like I said, if you're going to write a ballad, write something that is meaningful, that is sticking into your chest. That's what ballads are made for, is something sticks into your chest and it's personal. Write it down and belt it out like you need it, you want it. And I felt like she did that. With the music, was so dramatic and so... It feels like I'm listening to Hans Zimmer as well. And I love Hans Zimmer as a film composer. His music for Doom Part 2, loved it. I absolutely loved it. It was one of my favourites. I'm so glad I went to see that Doom Part 2 three times. And, well, you know, I'm a mega fan of Austin Butler. Like, a big fan of Austin Butler and Timothée Chalamet. So it does make sense of me seeing it three times. If you two are watching this video, you guys were amazing. I love Florence Plough, Zendaya, and the whole cast. If I can't pronounce other people's names, I do apologise. Hi. So yeah. Oh God, if they see that video, I'll be like, oh. So yeah. With the whole tone of that whole album and the structure of the album, it's just so true Sheryl Crow style. It's that alternative style. Like at that time, a lot of this new trend of style that we're trying to look sexy, we're trying to look beautiful and everything else. Looking sexy nowadays doesn't exist anymore in music videos. If you can sing and you've got talent and you've got great songwriting techniques and you've got great music style, that is what is important in this generation. I don't know why sex appeal exists, really. I don't really agree with sexualization and everything. It's like going back to Dune now. An actress I like, Zendaya, got that name right. Her character was never sexualized in whatsoever, and every film I watched her in, she's never been sexualized in everything, because she is a beautiful, beautiful woman. A beautiful woman and a very good actress. And she knows that being sexualized is not a good thing. And I think, yeah, honestly, like every role she's done, she's never sexualized in anything, which is brilliant. Honestly, appearance does not make you... Appearance, making you look sexy doesn't make you look successful. You do get played on a pond of being the poster girl or the poster boy, which, like, literally, that whole thing does not make sense anymore. If you've got great talent, that's all it matters. And I really strongly believe that if you think you've got good acting and you've got good acting talent, like, everyone can do everything. It does not make sense. No one can not do this. If someone's saying that to you, possibly don't contact that person ever again. If you can do it, you can do it. Doesn't matter. It really does not matter anymore. So, like that, I love the whole tone of the album, the positivity, the passion ballads that Sheryl Crow has put in. I do apologise for putting that side note in. I should remind you guys there's side note, this and that, the other. With Sheryl Crow's music, I absolutely adore the positivity that Sheryl Crow has put into this generation. Like, honestly, listening to her all over again, I just love the positivity that she put in her songwriting and the passion she has put in as well. I really do love that. I don't have any negatives. I loved it overall. So overall, bravo, bravo. I have to say, Sheryl Crow, you have delivered one of the best albums possible. This is absolutely amazing, really timely. And I've been trying to go see you live in concert for nearly all my life. And I know you went to Nottingham twice. Been to Nottingham twice performing there. I was been trying to go and see you live. I've been trying to go see you when you did the your first concert to Nottingham, and then your second one. I've been working like a house on fire to see you in Nottingham, because you're just an amazing artist. I love your music. I always will listen to your music, like, and everything. So thank you so much. I'm so sorry with the side rants when I mention Hans Zimmer. It's just because one of the ballads in Evolution reminds me of Hans Zimmer, and then that memory came out. I like went to see it twice. But no, not twice, three times. So yeah, I was just like, that was the point I was trying to make and everything else. And sorry I went sidetracked a little bit, but just to let you know, like, with Sheryl Crow's music, she's all about positivity and everything else. I never had a negative about her music, especially on this album, which is absolutely incredible. Go and listen to this album. Or if you don't know who Sheryl Crow is, go and listen to all of her music and all of her songs, and then listen to her new album. Because her new album is absolutely brilliant, and I absolutely adore it. And I will strongly advise you all to go and listen to her music. And thank you for watching. Make sure you give this video a like and a thumbs up onto the video. Go share it with friends and everybody. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Stay in tune. Bye.